Hello students, everybody. I am going to discuss a rule, sir, to determine the direction of magnetic field. First rule, right hand palm rule number 1. If we stretch our right hand such that the thumb point in the direction of current I and the finger towards the point P at which the direction of magnetic field is to be determined, then the perpendicular turn from the palm will give the direction of magnetic field B. Second rule, right hand thumb rule. According to this rule, if we grasp a straight conductor in our right hand such that thumb points in the direction of the current, then the finger curls in the direction of magnetic field. If the direction of magnetic field B with fingertips point along the vector, B means direction of B. And third rule, Maxwell's right hand screw rule. If we hold a screw in our right hand such and rotate it such that the screw tips moves in the direction of the current in conductor, then the direction rotation of thumb give the direction of magnetic field lines of force. As shown in figure, current and this screw moves in the direction of current, then the rotation of this finger give the direction of magnetic field lines here inward and this point at P dash upward to magnetic field and at P inward to magnetic field. Now come on the figure related to these three rules. Figure 4 for the rule 1, figure 2 for the second and figure 3 for the third. Application of Biot-Savart law. First, magnetic field gives the state field due to straight current carrying conductor. Let us consider a current carrying conductor CB and this is the point P. Distance from O, that is perpendicular distance, this and current element, this IDL, this is Q. Let us consider a state current conductor CD and perpendicular distance of the point P, where we require to calculate the magnetic field from the current carrying conductor CD, that is A, and a current element, its midpoint is IDL, midpoint O joined to point P makes angle phi, and this direction theta to the direction of current, and joined C and D from the point P, consider the makes angle phi 1 from QP and this PD make phi 2. This OP equal to R
एंड ओ टी इक्वल टू एल। इन फिगर क्यू पी इक्वल टू ए एंड सी डी स्टेट कंडक्टर स्ट्रेट करंट कैरिंग कंडक्टर एंड ओ क्यू इक्वल टू एल एंगल क्यू ओ पी इक्वल टू थीटा एंगल एंगल क्यू पी ओ इक्वल टू फाइव एंगल सी सी पी ओ इक्वल टू फाइव वन एंगल डी पी सी पी क्यू इक्वल टू फाइव वन डी पी क्यू इक्वल टू फाइव टू अकॉर्डिंग टू बायोट सेवर्ट लॉ द मैग्नेटिक फील्ड मैग्नेटिक फील्ड एट पी ड्यू टू स्मॉल करंट एलिमेंट स्मॉल करंट एलिमेंट आई डी एल इक्वल टू डी इक्वल टू डी इक्वल टू म्यू नॉट अपॉन फोर पाई आई डी एल साइन थीटा अपॉन आर स्क्वायर इन ट्रायंगल पी क्यू ओ थीटा प्लस फाइव इक्वल टू नाइन्टी थीटा इक्वल टू नाइन्टी डिग्री माइनस फाइव साइन थीटा इक्वल टू साइन नाइन्टी माइनस फाइव मीन साइन थीटा इक्वल टू कॉस फाइव पी क्यू अपॉन ओ पी इक्वल टू कॉस फाइव पी क्यू ए बाई आर इक्वल टू कॉस फाइव आर इक्वल टू ए अपॉन कॉस फाइव मीन्स ए सेक फाइव आर इक्वल टू ए सेक फाइव This is third. Q O upon Q P equal to tan phi and Q O L upon A equal to tan phi and L equal to A tan phi D L इक्वल टू ए sec स्क्वायर phi d phi डिफरेंशिएटिंग इज दिस इज अ फोर्थ पुट द वैल्यू ऑफ पुट द वैल्यू ऑफ साइन थीटा आर एंड डी एल इन इक्वेशन वन वी गेट डी वी इक्वल टू म्यू नॉट अपॉन फोर पाई आई डी एल इक्वल टू ए सिक्स स्क्वायर फाइव डी एल इक्वल टू ए टेन पाई का सिक्स स्क्वायर फाइव साइन थीटा सिक्स स्क्वायर फाइव डी फाइव साइन थीटा वैल्यू that is cos phi, and r equal to that r equal to a sec phi whole square. And is dv equal to solving, you will get mu upon 4 pi I by a cos phi d phi.
All of write down first each and every step.
The magnetic, the total due to the due to total total magnetic field due to conductor CD V equal to
here minus 512, 52 I will integrate this dV, minus 512 integrate this mu 0 upon 4 pi I by A cos phi d phi. Now come on,
V equal to mu naught upon 4 pi I and A, I upon A that cos phi sin phi phi 2 to minus phi 1. Therefore V equal to mu naught upon 4 pi I by A sin phi 2 I limit minus sin minus pi 1, that V equal to mu naught upon 4 pi I by A sin phi 2 here and minus sin minus pi, minus sin pi may be written, so minus sin minus pi 1 minus minus plus sin pi 1, so that you may be rearrange sin phi 1 plus sin phi 2, where A perpendicular distance from CD of point P. Vector V directed inward plane paper. Case if for a conductor of infinite length, for a conductor of infinite length, length phi 1 equal to phi 2 equal to 90, then P equal to mu naught upon 4 pi I by A sin 90 plus sin 90. After solving, you will get V equal to mu naught upon 4 pi I by A into 2, V equal to mu naught upon 4 pi 2 pi 2 to cancel I by A. केस टू केस टू इफ पी लाइज एट एंड इफ पी लाइज एट एंड से बी देन then 5-1 equal to 90 and 5-2 equal to 0. Therefore, B become mu naught upon 4 pi I by A sin 90 plus sin 0. Therefore, B equal to on solving, we will get 4 pi I by A. Is third from this also it is clear that B and this A if point P lies at bisector of current conductor of length, current carrying conductor of length of length L as shown in figure, L by 2, this phi, and this A, then then 5-1 equal to 5-2 equal to 5 sin and CP equal to A square plus L by 2 whole square CP equal to 4 A square plus L square by 2. Therefore, sin 5 equal to this perpendicular upon hypotenuse L by 2 upon 4 A square plus L square by 2 multiplying it become L upon root 4 A square plus L square. Now put the value in this V equal to mu naught upon 4 pi I by A sin phi plus sin phi, that V equal to mu naught upon 4 pi I by A 2 sin phi. Put the value of sin phi from this V equal to mu naught upon 4 pi I by A 2 into L upon 4 A square plus L square V equal to mu naught upon 2 pi I by A L upon 4 A square plus L square. Thus we can derive the relation. I have taken the base of RA here.